Hi everyone, my name is Heather and I'm the person behind Happy Puppy Truffles. Today I wanted to show you guys another fun way to display origami for the holiday season. And we're going to be using a shikishi, or a display board that you use in Japan. We use these for calligraphy, for artwork, and you see them a lot of times for origami as well. You can certainly use any kind of board. You could use cardboard, you could use mat board. That works really great too. But really anything that you can find, and if it has a nice clean surface, you can leave it the way it is. If you want to layer it with a piece of paper over top like I've done for this one, you can do that too. I just used some nice fibrous handmade paper here to kind of give a cool little background vibe. Now this particular kind of arrangement is meant to kind of showcase a certain kind of origami paper, or any paper really, wrapping paper, that you might have that you really like and you want to kind of showcase a piece. What you're doing is just taking the piece of paper and having it represent a square gift box. And then you don't have to fold, you get to use and show the entire piece of paper. I know I have some really cute Totoro paper that I would probably love to do this for, because I don't have to fold the paper, I don't hurt it in any way, you get to see the whole design. Sometimes, you know, origami paper has something really cute over here in the corner, and then when you folded everything up, you can never see it, and it just seems like a waste. So if you have paper that you treasure, like I know I do, I have scraps here and there from when I was even a small child of wrapping paper that I loved. So if there's some things like that, you can use this kind of a setup and kind of create a nice way to save some paper that's special to you. Now, all we do to make it really simple is you've got your paper, and then maybe if you want, you can put a layer here on top to represent like a ribbon. And then what I did is I went ahead and folded a foil ribbon on top to kind of match, because this paper I'm using here is foil based. It's this Midori origami paper. I've shown you guys a review of this before. Such pretty paper with the snowflakes on it. And I love the way that it kind of is less snow on top and more on the bottom. So certainly when you fold it, maybe you kind of lose some of that impact. But so what I basically have here is this paper, this strip is a quarter of my paper, just as a guide. And my ribbon here was made just with the same thing. You use a full sheet of paper cut in half, so it's 7.5 by 15, and it gives me a pretty good size bow. If you really wanted a really big bow, you could try to adjust your sizing a little bit. And then I wanted to also showcase the pink version of this paper. So I'm just going to have one of these boxes sitting on the side, kind of with nothing on it, to kind of give some variety. And then down here in the corner, I was going to put another little box, and this time have it be the silver that I used here, and put a little bow from the paper that I have here. This particular paper is 2/3 the size of a regular size piece of paper, and then I just used this little leftover bit to create the ribbon that I have here. And I just decided to go ahead and glue that right in the middle of this square. And that square is 1/4 of the size of paper. So pretty easy to do with just a couple scraps. I think essentially I used 4 pieces of paper. There was this half and then another split here for the silver, and then I had to have another piece of paper for the smaller square. Then one of the pinks and one of the pretty purpley black ones too. So certainly doesn't have to just be for Christmas. Anytime you want to give gifts, I think, you know, this would be such a pretty thing to put in a nursery for a newborn baby, maybe with the wrapping paper from one of their first gifts. Just a lot of fun different ways you can do this. You can give it as a birthday gift, so many things, and it's not that hard. So, but we'll go ahead and glue all this down here and show you guys. I'll have a link so that you can remind yourself how to make a ribbon if you need help with that. But otherwise, not a whole lot of folding, just a little bit of arranging of the kinds of things you enjoy in terms of the paper you like. So I'm just going to start off here by first laying down my big piece of paper here with a bit of glue. Sometimes I find that foil paper just doesn't like to take glue. The back side will, but the other side may not. I'm like having a little problem here with my bow sticking. I'll show you guys here in a second. You might need to use some super industrial strength glue. But again, I want to make sure I have enough room up here at the top for my ribbon without it getting too high up. But I want to have room down at the bottom for the other gifts too, so find a good spot. Glue things down. And you know, you might try different kinds of material, different kinds of glues to see which ones work better for certain kinds of paper. Sometimes double-sided tape might work better. Just kind of depends on which ones you guys are working with here. Let me put this nice little strip. Hopefully this glue will take. And metallic paper is a little less forgiving. If you get a little bit of glue on it, it has a tendency to show. So, you know, you might be able to smear it off a little bit if you find that you get some on there. And then I've got my big guy here. And I'm going to even try to put a little on all parts of it just to really give myself some chance for this to stick somewhere. Because I think it's not going to cooperate as well as I'd like it to. And then got this little square that I was going to add at the bottom. And you could certainly change up the shape of your boxes. You could do some rectangular shapes. I just kept mine square just to kind of keep things simple. But, you know, you can definitely use all sorts of shapes for your presents. It doesn't have to be just one kind of shape necessarily. Yeah, and this particular one, I might not have given it enough time to dry yet, but it seems like it's having a little hard time taking the glue. So test your glues, too, depending on the kind of paper you're using. I don't want you guys to run into any trouble with things not sticking. But, you know, then if you want, of course, you can always add messages and things like that to stuff, or you can leave it kind of abstract like this. But it's a super easy, nice, fun way to kind of you know, commemorate a moment or save a particular kind of paper that you might like. But that should kind of give you guys the finished little project here for this. And if I'll be having lots of more fun projects for you guys as we get closer and closer to Christmas. So thank you always so much for watching, and I'll see you guys next time.